Very good morning to all of you. I find almost all the faces are familiar here. That also shows that I have become old in this activities of addressing the and meeting the automobile sector and the stakeholders in this automobile. Well, so my friends on the dais, it was last about 40 minutes sitting here, a lot of learning for me. And let me tell you, I never knew so much about the safety issues, and particularly what Rajiv spoke and what Mr. Pandey spoke. And I was just jotting down the ideas which were coming to my mind. So probably I would be speaking about those more rather than coming out with any policy, because policy ki baat karna to it's a politician's prerogative, and I am not a spokesperson for NITI Aayog or for the government. So I will be speaking what I feel like speaking. Rajiv yahan pe hai nahi, but I must congratulate jo pichle last about a year or a year and a half I'm trying to answer, trying to find an answer to the question whether the chicken came first or whether the egg came first. So he has very beautifully answered my question, and I'm really feeling very happy today morning that Rajiv said, yes, one should move forward, one should go ahead. So that is the probably the spirit of what MG is following, and I must congratulate MG. We don't have many OEMs present here, but that is the message which should go maybe from my friends Deepanshu or his your outfit can pick it up. That was an excellent thing what Rajiv spoke. Pandeji spoke about a very, very enlightening presentation from him as to how safety could be taken up. And in the last, he mentioned about the learning or the skills. What as a policymaker or being an ex-public servant, or even right now also I am in the public service, I feel that the last point which he mentioned should be the first priority in these kind of a things. We were also just talking, for any Jan Andolan, it is not a question of who is taking it forward. Unless the last element is involved in that, any mass movement does not succeed. I am probably repeating the same thing which I spoke maybe a week earlier. I remember the days when there used to be a family planning campaign. So at that time, it used to be from the top that compulsory operations, sterilization of women and operations of the men. Then we had, what happened? Now the situation is that after 40 years of that, 35 years of that, it is adopted. Because now everybody, all the stakeholders are part of it. In early 90s, we have Andolan, we have movement for literacy. The kids used to go for, I'm from the hinterland, used to work in Madhya Pradesh as an administrative officer, and used to see that the kids are being sent for cow grazing and taking the herds for their grazing rather than being sent to the schools. But after that literacy movement and so much of the things, I realized that within 10 to 15 years of time, the school, the villagers started asking for the schools in their own village. At least there should be a primary school in the village, they used to demand. Similarly, now the Prime Minister has launched or has is campaigning for a Swachhata. And I'm very sure that in time to come, if all the stakeholders join it, then sanitation or the swachhata will also become an outcome, then probably we will not be needing to talk about it. And friends, in a similar way, probably we take on this safety movement. How do we take it forward unless all the stakeholders become part of it? We talk of a lot of things, whether it is the driver assistance system, ADAS, or the other technological things. But these things are bound to, because these things take certain assumptions. When we talk about the safety, in a Western environment, it is different probably, and it is different in Indian context. Friends, India is different. We have to handle the issues differently in India. We make 80% of our automobiles are two-wheelers. We have the largest density, and because of that, our infrastructure for the roads is really and really constrained. You broaden the roads. I'm coming from Dhola Kuma. A few days back, I was very happy that it has been broadened. But again, today I had a jam there, which took me 10 minutes, and that delayed me my arrival here. So whatever, however wide you widen the road, there are vehicles to fill the width. So that's not a solution. We have to reduce the number of vehicles on the roads. So friends, I was saying that India is different. Indian context is different. We have more two-wheelers, less passenger vehicle ownership. And similarly, when we talk about the safety, when we talk about the ADAS, or when we talk about the safety issues which are in a developed society or a developed country, there are certain assumptions about the person who is driving the vehicle. Those assumptions do not hold good in the Indian context. You assume certain skills, you assume certain awareness of the person, of the driver, of the cleaner, or the person who is managing that terror on the road to have it. But if it doesn't have it, then now how do we use the technology to take this level upwards, bring them at the same platform, and then probably take on the technologies which are promoted and propagated by the developed countries or in the advanced automobiles and the advanced cars? Friends, that's a million-dollar question, and we have to address that. And unless we do not address it, it will be extremely difficult. It's very easy to talk things in a limited audience. It's very easy to implement or do something at the micro level, but the moment you try to escalate the size, the moment you try to take it forward, it becomes difficult. And that is the problem which Mr. Pandey was also discussing with me, as to how do we take it forward. Yes, of course, we have issues. We have to join our energies. We have to join our groups. We have to give away with our egos and work for this national cause of safety, where there are 17 deaths every hour, 150,000 deaths in a year, which are also said to be much, much lower than the actual figures, because the accidents do not get reported, because the accidents are reported through an FIR through the police department. Now, yesterday only, there was a suggestion by another non-profit organization working in the same areas, suggested me the accidents recording should be through the health department, so that actually the real pictures do emerge as to how many accidents did take place. So friends, there are multiple issues. I really don't know if I start talking about it, these 15 minutes which have been kept in front of me, which will certainly become very, very short, because there are so many issues to talk about. A very interesting thing said by that accident is taken as a jadu tona. Friends, I remember just 3 or 4 days back, when the failure of the Chandrayaan is also being analyzed, because of some so aap jo accident ki baat aur jo hai, so that is what it is, that the awareness, I was talking about awareness. I remember in one of the administrative positions, I was in I was a Jabalpur commissioner those days, and my own ADM there. What happens? The farmers take their crop, they take their crop early in the morning to take it to the mandi. Now, those tractors and the trolleys, and those trolleys just never have the backlights. You look at the, and my own ADM met with an accident, multiple fractures, just because the trolley was moving in front, which didn't have any backlight, and if you are moving even at the speed of 60 to 70, it becomes difficult. So the question is that of the awareness. What will you do with those kind of systems where the marriage parties, the marriage processions do travel on the tractor trolleys in most of the villagers, most of the interiors of the Hindi heartland, or even in the southern India also. The barat goes in the tractor trolleys. So these are the realities of this country, and how do we handle it? How do we scale up the whole thing? That is the most critical issue. It's more of a social problem. It's because of the because of the social, economic milieu which is prevailing in the country, and in that milieu we have to find out a solution. But friends, campaign mode is the only mode which could be successful, and it has to percolate down. Now, being in the think tank NITI Aayog, we do prescribe, we do come out with our ideas on the policy issues. There is so much of the informal sector associated in the automobile, whether it is the mechanic culture, or whether it is the in the maintenance of the vehicles, even in the scrapping issues. The government is planning to come out with a scrapping policy, and there are a major consideration, major issue which we deliberate, which we discuss, is that how to bring in the informal scrapping centers to the formal scrapping centers. The entire scrapping of the vehicle is done in an informal sector. Hardly there is one center in Noida, in the under the Ministry of Steel, but otherwise there is hardly any. Similarly, we say that more than 30 million people are employed in the automobile sector, but how many of them are formally in the maintenance of the vehicle segment? I remember 20 years back when I bought my car in US, and I was really surprised to find out the maintenance systems over there, the kind of garages, the kind of workshops, and the kind of systems which they have. And if they certify a vehicle for a year, however old it could be, it runs for a year. And then after 1 year, you again have to obtain a certificate. And the same OEMs, same manufacturers, when they come to India, they do not follow the same standards. This is the unfortunate part. And I don't have anything to hide this fact. This is a fact that we do not follow when we come here. Maybe there are reasons, but then at some point of time, friends, we have to consider that our people are also equally skilled, equally aware, and they are at the same platform. India is developing, India is growing, we are aspiring. And none other than our Prime Minister is repeatedly saying 5 trillion economy. Now 5 trillion economy will certainly percolate down to the per capita GDP also. And we have to understand the things which are there, have to be given to the people at the common level. Yes, technology provides opportunities. We have adopted BS6 in the record time. Not yet adopted, but going to succeed in following BS6 in the record time, which is an indication as to if we decide to do something, we do it much faster than any other developed country or the developed economy. Similarly, friends, how to have the technology to reduce the manual intervention even in the controlling the vehicle or managing the vehicle or the safety. Very interesting. I was seeing the film, a quite educative film, which was shown as to how the safety system should be there. When the lanes are not there, then how do you follow the lane driving, which is also correct. And then the argument is also valid that yes, there are lanes somewhere, start following it. So all the stakeholders have to come together, the manufacturers, the component manufacturers, the maintenance people, the mechanics, and finally the user, the passenger who is driving that vehicle, who is using the vehicle, or everybody has to come together, and then only, and of course, the most important is the government. Look at the softness of our state. We are all having a lot of jokes on the WhatsApp, internet, and everywhere about the amount of fines which have been imposed with the changes, amendments in the Motor Vehicle Act. Friend, why should there be a question of a fine? Why should be there a fine? Why should you drive while being drunk? You are complaining about the fine, that fine is too high for driving a vehicle without a helmet, for without wearing the seat belt, without having the proper document with you. You are crying, everybody is crying about the fine. But why should there be a question about violating any norm? We have to get into that mindset. And friends, we are all the elites. And when we are talking about it, then look at the man who is at the not so privileged to come here and sit in these kind of environments. We just say whatever is the fine, we will just not violate the any norms, any rules, any laws. Why should there be any fine? But then it is assumed that there will be violation, so the fine should be less. It should be small. It should be affordable. So affordable penalty system. I really used to wonder about it as to why it should be why it should be like that. So friends, and the challenges are really great. I was thinking about the evolution of mobility, the system which is started ages years old. We have a very old civilization. We have the mobility, or we have the transportation systems which have evolved over time, right from the evolution or the invention of the wheels, and then all that process which has taken place. But then in that system, how to incorporate, how to adopt the newer technologies, the latest cutting edge technologies is very critical. As a policy framework, I must say that we have to put in the efforts when we are able to take these things to the grassroots levels, take it as a campaign. We have to make it a campaign. It's a good cause. But I must say that the leadership and the elites and everybody has to follow this. I wish all the best to the ET, the Autotech organization, the setup which you have. And I'm sure that you have a strong tool to take it forward. It's an opportunity. I'm thankful for this opportunity, for being here. But friends, it's a very noble cause. It's a great cause, and we really need to take it forward. Thank you very much.